Bugger.
He was worse than dead. His brain is gone.
If you watched the previous video, which should be appearing somewhere around here, hopefully, you'll know we've been playing around with some high voltage circuits to drive these LED filaments, which I got out of some broken light bulbs. It's a very simple circuit. There's a MOSFET, an inductor, a diode, and a smoothing capacitor. And we're simply switching the inductor off and on at a high frequency. So currently I've got it hooked up to my signal generator, and we're running a duty cycle of 10%. So if I just ramp up that duty cycle, then we can get up to a pretty high voltage. So these diodes start to light around about 90 volts, and we can go up to around 95, 96, and get sort of fairly bright light. This meter only starts to register current after about 20 milliamps. So this circuit works pretty well, but as I say, it is quite Heath Robinson. So you can see all of this stuff on the breadboard. This is the remains of a capacitor that got blown up. So the problem is I've only got some fairly low voltage capacitors, so maximum of 100 volts. And I went over 100 volts. It worked for some time, and then the capacitor exploded. Now, I don't know if that was a failure of the diode or the MOSFET, because these MOSFETs have also been blowing up. So I'm just testing one of the failed ones here, and it's turned into a resistor divider, which is not ideal. So I thought what I'd do is invest in a proper DC-DC converter. So I bought one of these. Now, this will go from 45 to 350 volts on the output. I have both the negative and positive, so in theory we can get 700 volts out of this. Now, I have seen some videos on YouTube. These have been around for a couple of years, so there's plenty of videos to find. You can get the negative to go almost minus 400. So if you go from negative to positive, you can get around 800 volts out of these circuits. So that's pretty impressive. But obviously, this one's dead. I started using it. It was working, but it was making a very strange sound, a sort of clicking sound. And then it just failed. And the input is now shorted together. There is a vaguely suspicious burn mark here, but I can't remember if that was there before. Now, this does get pretty hot, but not excessively so. And most of the video reviews I watched talk about how hot this board actually gets, and it does get too hot to actually touch when it's running. There is a connector for a fan, which may be useful if I actually get another one that works. But let's pop this under the microscope and see if we can work out why it blew up. But before we get into the PCBs, let's talk about PCB Way. They do multicoloured PCBs, they do flexible PCBs, they do 3D printing, and they do CNC machining. They pretty much do everything. So check them out, there's a link in the description. So I think the first thing to notice is this board's pretty disgusting, really. Could be improved. I mean, my soldering's not great, but this does look pretty bad. I mean, could that be a short there? I mean, I don't think it is, but it definitely looks a bit crusty. So I think what we should do is clean this board up and have a look at it once it's nicely cleaned. So a bit of isopropyl alcohol and a toothbrush, and our board is now nice and clean, nice and shiny. So let's have a look at what we've got on the board. So let's see if I can read the numbers. So that's a 78L09, so that's a 9 volt regulator. Here's the switching supply, so UCS3843B. I'll try and dig out a datasheet for this. And LM393, so an op amp. Let's see if we can find a schematic online. There's a few diodes dotted around. And that's kind of it, really. So just checking that our short circuit is still there, and it is. So I'm getting a beep from the multimeter. So yeah, definitely still have a short circuit. Let's have a look at the output side of things. So we have these two diodes, so let's check these. So I think this diode is the positive supply output rail. That seems to be fine. Yep, that's definitely working okay. And then this one, well, that's a bit weird. This one seems to be a short circuit. So that's definitely not what we want. So there's something wrong with this diode. Now, I don't know if that's a different problem from the short circuit on our input, but it's certainly not right. So what I might do is I'll remove this, and I'll probably also remove the MOSFET, and we'll see if we can see if they're working okay. So I also want to take a look at this, what could be a burn mark? I'm not sure if it is looking under the microscope, but let's see if we can peel up this insulation and see what's underside. It's quite difficult to actually get this off. This transformer seems quite well constructed. Well, that looks completely fine. Yeah, I can't see any problems there, so not the issue. So let's get this diode and the MOSFET desoldered, and then we'll do some testing on them. So I've got the diode here, and I've also got the MOSFET. I've had to solder on some little wires to the MOSFET because they were very short. Let's test out the diode first. So let's go into, sorry about that clicking. Let's go into the diode mode on the multimeter. I think you can see that. The light's shining on you slightly. That's still pretty bad. There we go, that's better. I think you can see that okay. So let's see what our diode is showing. So going this way. Yeah, well that's definitely not right, is it? So we have 0.05 volts drop across the diode, and that's pretty much a short circuit, isn't it? And then going the other way, what do we have? Yeah, it's short circuit as well. It's pretty much a resistor, isn't it? Let's see what the resistance is. If we can actually measure such a low resistance. 30 ohms. So our diode has turned into a resistor. Not very good. And then let's see what our MOSFET is. Well, yeah, like the MOSFETs that I've destroyed, this one's turned into a voltage divider with a very low voltage between pins 2 and 3. So that'll be the gate, so drain and source are basically shorted together. So also not very good. Well, yeah, this didn't last very long, did it? Not ideal. So yeah, we've destroyed it. Destroyed. Now I've removed these components. Desoldering the MOSFET, I lost one of the pads. Desoldering the diode was pretty okay. I should have probably used my hot air workstation for the desoldering, but I tried to do it with a soldering iron. So I've ordered another one, a replacement. Hopefully that will come soon, and we can actually do the experiment we initially set out to do, which is lighting these stupid filaments.